Before I get into today's content, please give us a big thumbs up if you find value in our videos. Helps us to get the word out and grow the channel, and I'd really appreciate it. And make sure to stay tuned until the end of the video for a special news announcement. I want to tell you about a high quality stock that pays big, growing, reliable dividends. These growing dividends are funded by growing profit because this business is providing life-saving and life-improving medical devices. Healthcare is in secular growth mode. With the world gaining population and people living longer than ever, that's just a fact. This bodes well for healthcare companies in general, but it especially bodes well for companies like this one that are involved in the more non-discretionary side of healthcare. That means growing profits and growing dividends. I personally invested in stocks just like this one on my way to going from below broke at age 27 to financially free at 33. By the way, I explain exactly how I achieved financial freedom in just 6 years in my early retirement blueprint. If you're interested, you can download a free copy of my early retirement blueprint using the link in the description of this video. Getting back to the stock I'll tell you about today though, perhaps best of all, it looks undervalued right now. Price is what you pay, but value is what you get. Why is that important? Because buying a dividend growth stock when it's undervalued should provide for a higher yield, greater long-term total return potential, and reduced risk. With this in mind, I want to share with you an opportunity I recently came across in shares of Medtronic PLC, which appear to be trading at a significant discount today. Medtronic PLC stock ticker MDT is a global developer and manufacturer of medical devices for chronic diseases. Founded in 1949, Medtronic is now a $157 billion by market cap healthcare giant that employs 90,000 people. The company reports results across four segments: cardiovascular, 36% of fiscal year 2021 revenue, medical surgical, 29%, neuroscience, 27%, and diabetes, 8%. Their product portfolio includes implantable defibrillators, heart valves, insulin pumps, pacemakers, stents, and surgical tools. Medtronic is in the business of providing healthcare that saves and/or improves lives. And they're a leader in doing so. From Morningstar, and I quote, "Medtronic has historically held roughly 50% share in its core heart devices. It's also the market leader in spinal products, insulin pumps, and neuromodulators for chronic pain," unquote. What's appealing about Medtronic from an investor's point of view is the secular growth of healthcare in general, as well as the non-discretionary nature of this kind of healthcare specifically. With the world growing larger, older, and wealthier, you naturally end up with a bigger pool of people who need and can financially access quality healthcare options. That's the secular growth story. In addition, these products specifically aren't a discretionary expenditure in most cases. If, for instance, you need heart surgery, this is not something you're going to negotiate or delay. You get a level of certainty here in terms of the business model, and that translates to a level of certain growth in profits and certain growth in dividends. Already, Medtronic has increased its dividend for 44 consecutive years. This is a vaunted dividend aristocrat, which is reserved for stocks with at least 25 consecutive years of dividend increases. The 10-year dividend growth rate is 10%, and that double-digit dividend growth is paired with a starting yield of 2.2%. That is well ahead of what the broader market offers in terms of yield. This yield is also slightly higher than the stock's own 5-year average yield. With a low payout ratio of 44.2% based on midpoint guidance for this fiscal year's adjusted earnings per share, the dividend is secure and positioned to continue growing. One might wish to see a higher yield, but the dividend growth rate makes this an excellent long-term compounder. Looking at business growth, Medtronic grew its revenue from $16.2 billion in fiscal year 2012 to $30.1 billion in fiscal year 2021. That's a compound annual growth rate of 7.1%. Very solid top-line growth, but we have to keep in mind that much of this growth was a result of the acquisition of Covidien PLC in 2015 for almost $50 billion. This complementary addition to the company, with Covidien focusing on endomechanical instruments, adding to Medtronic's cardiovascular and orthopedic offerings, gave a large boost to the top line. Meanwhile, earnings per share increased from $3.41 to $4.44 adjusted over this period, which is a compound annual growth rate of 3%. I used adjusted earnings per share for fiscal year 2021 as Medtronic moved its headquarters to Ireland following the Covidien acquisition, and this has resulted in a lumpiness in GAAP earnings per share. While this long-term earnings per share growth rate might seem disappointing,
almost the entirety of fiscal year 2021 was negatively impacted by the pandemic, hospitals have had to prioritize COVID-19 issues, which has delayed elective procedures and other healthcare that isn't imminently life-threatening. If we factor out the pandemic, Medtronic's long-term bottom-line growth is actually more in line with its long-term dividend growth. That is to say, it's in the high single-digit range. For perspective, Q3, fiscal year 2020, the company's most recent normal pre-pandemic quarter, reported in February 2020, showed 12% year-over-year growth in adjusted earnings per share. Looking forward, CFRA is forecasting that Medtronic will compound its earnings per share at an annual rate of 10% over the next 3 years. CFRA sees a near-term bottom-line growth acceleration for Medtronic, and this makes sense. Recent results for the company have been hurt by delays in elective surgeries, but these are delays, not cancellations. It's simply a bottleneck that results in a backlog, which will likely end up causing an explosive unwinding of that pent-up demand as the healthcare complex normalizes. Indeed, CFRA notes this, and I quote, "Given Medtronic's broad lineup of new products and its high exposure to elective procedures, we expect the company to generate strong results as healthcare systems recover from the impact of COVID-19, unquote. I can also point to Medtronic's fiscal year 2022 guidance, which calls for 28.4% year-over-year growth in adjusted earnings per share at the midpoint. Of course, this is only a short-term tailwind. However, CFRA believes there's a more permanent benefit at play here, and I quote, "Medtronic also stands out from medical device peers because of its strong financial position, which has probably helped the company capture market share during the pandemic." That viewpoint is supported by the company. CEO Jeff Martha recently spoke on CNBC and stated the company has, and I quote, "gained share in nearly every business that we have, with one or two exceptions," unquote. This is coming from a market position that was already very impressive. In the end, I think it's prudent to expect the status quo more or less over the long run, and the status quo is very, very good here. That would translate to high single-digit or low double-digit dividend growth, which is paired with a 2% plus starting yield. I imagine long-term shareholders would welcome this. Moving over to the balance sheet, the company has a good financial position. I actually disagree with CFRA's language on this. They called Medtronic's financial position strong. I think it's only good, and it could and should be improved. Medtronic actually used to have a phenomenal balance sheet. The Covidien acquisition changed that. The long-term debt-to-equity ratio is 0.5, while the interest coverage ratio is slightly over 5. It's that latter number which concerns me, and I'd like to see some improvement there in coming years. Profitability is quite robust. Over the last 5 years, the firm has averaged annual net margin of 13.4% and annual return on equity of 7.9%. I believe the profitability is better than it looks, as the GAAP numbers distort their true earnings power. Medtronic offers long-term dividend growth investors a lot to like, and the company has durable competitive advantages that include IP, R&D, switching costs, scale, a global distribution network, high barriers to entry, and a diversified portfolio of entrenched products. Of course, there are risks to consider. Regulation, litigation, and competition are omnipresent risks in every industry. Regulation and litigation risks are both elevated relative to other business models. Any changes in the way healthcare spending is managed, especially in the United States, would almost certainly impact the company. These are recession-proof products for the most part, but economic slowdowns can cause a delay in some treatments. The company is also exposed to technology risks. Any large, fast technological changes in medical devices can alter the competitive landscape. With these risks out in the open, Medtronic still appears to be highly appealing as a long-term investment. That's especially so with the recent 17% drop in the stock's price, creating a compelling valuation. The stock is trading hands for a forward price earnings ratio of 19.9 based on midpoint guidance for this fiscal year's adjusted earnings per share. I think that's quite reasonable in this market, particularly for a company of this quality. Meantime, the price to cash flow ratio of 21.2 is right in line with its own 5-year average, and the yield, as noted earlier, is higher than its own recent historical average. I valued shares using a dividend discount model analysis. I factored in a 10% discount rate and a long-term dividend growth rate of 7.5%. This is on the high end of what I normally allow for, although it's not the highest I'll go. I think Medtronic earns this number. It's well below their own demonstrated long-term dividend growth rate. It's also below the anticipated near-term bottom-line growth rate, and the payout ratio is low, giving them even more flexibility here. I believe Medtronic will have no problem with this kind of dividend growth over the long run. If anything, this is slightly conservative. The dividend discount model analysis gives me a fair value of $108.36. The reason I use a dividend discount model analysis is because a business is ultimately equal to the sum of all the future cash flow it can provide. The dividend discount model analysis is a tailored version of the discounted cash flow model analysis, as it simply substitutes dividends and dividend growth for cash flow and growth. It then discounts those future dividends back to the present day to account for the time value of money, since a dollar tomorrow is not worth the same amount as a dollar today. I find it to be a fairly accurate way to value dividend growth stocks. Morningstar rates Medtronic as a 3-star stock with a fair value estimate of $129. CFRA rates Medtronic as a 4-star buy with a 12-month target price of $134. I came out low this time around, averaging the three numbers out, gives us a final valuation of $123.79, which would indicate the stock is possibly 9% undervalued. Here's the bottom line, guys. Medtronic PLC is a high-quality company that enjoys incredible market share and secular growth in its industry. With a market-beating yield, double-digit long-term dividend growth, a low payout ratio, more than 40 consecutive years of dividend increases, and the potential that shares are 9% undervalued, this is a dividend aristocrat that all long-term dividend growth investors should seriously consider for investment right now. And now for a special news announcement. RBC Capital just upgraded Chevron Corporation stock ticker CVX to outperform from sector perform. They also raised their target price to $145 from $130. We just highlighted Chevron in a video only days ago, noting how Warren Buffett's firm has been loading up on shares during Q3 of this year. If you haven't already taken a look at Chevron, it seems that now might be a good time to do so.
Thanks so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Give us a like if you did, and let us know in the comments what you think about this stock. Please make sure to subscribe to the channel and ring that notification bell so you don't miss out on new content. Also, take a look at the description box below for some important links, including the link to my personal stock portfolio. This six-figure portfolio, which I call the Fire Fund, generates enough passive dividend income for me to live off of. It allowed me to retire in my early 30s. I've made my portfolio entirely accessible over a Patreon, and I also post alerts there whenever I buy or sell a stock. I put my money where my mouth is, and I'm often invested in the same high-quality dividend growth stocks that I make videos on. Over the years, I've heard from thousands of investors who have been profiting from many of the same exact stocks that I own. So if you think this is something that you could benefit from as well, check the link in the description to see my portfolio and start getting my buy and sell alerts. I'll see you next time.